And David Baria and some of his colleagues at the Capitol say it's time to lift the lifetime ban on people who've completed their sentences. He says they pay taxes and as citizens should also have a say in decisions in their communities.
Representative David Baria says several bills in both the state Senate and House all aim to restore the vote to Mississippians who have paid their debt to society and are fully released from the State Department of Corrections.
We had a press conference today and we had two gentlemen there who had children. They were grown men. They were, you know, trying to live their lives like normal citizens, but they just have this albatross hanging around their necks.
He says many of those cases are people who committed crimes when they were young and made mistakes.
But they are forever barred from voting under Mississippi law.
Lawmakers supporting repealing the ban say between the years 1994 and 2017, nearly 50,000 residents lost their right to vote due to conviction. But the original intent of the current law on the books dates back to the state constitution of 1896 and a deliberate move to disenfranchise a particular group of voters.
This is one of those vestigial problems where we were trying to limit the rights of black folks to vote, and it has impacted a lot more than just black folks. You know, there are a lot of people in this state who this applies to.
Baria says other states have already dealt with the issue.
We did this in Florida and on the last ballot, and Florida is a state with a Republican governor and two Republican United States senators. We ought to do this in Mississippi.
Now, Baria tells me the people of the state approve of restoring voting rights by an overwhelming majority, upwards of 70%. But Governor Phil Bryant has opposed changing the law in the past. Troy Johnson, 16 WAPT News at 10.